Now I continue our journey of understanding why we should know the business and understand what the company is doing before we invest in the stock market. So we are in the third part of this series of understanding the fundamentals for the beginners. What we covered earlier is that why it's important for us to know the business. The next part is you will never buy, promise yourself that you will never buy a stock by reading a newspaper headline. Please use your head before you invest your hard-earned money. Headlines are created after the game is over. So if you get to hear a company X is increasing its price by 30% in the last 1 week, don't get your money and invest in that share, because maybe the potential of that company was only 30% and which is already reaped. There is a separate video on how the scams work. I will put the link in the description below so that you can have a look at that video as well. So to continue, the next point is management is everything. It's important to understand the management and how they are handling the business, because if the management is honest and efficient, they will turn around the business. And that's the very important point for you to remember. And you can track that by what the management had done in the previous companies that they worked in, or what they have done from the time they have joined this company at a respectable position. And that will speak tons for you. The next point is there are 1,000 companies. There are thousands of companies. So don't forget that opportunities are also equally there. So if you feel that, okay, the price of X has already ripped up by 20%, 50% or so in the last 1 month or last 3 months, sometimes you get news that, okay, the company Y had grown 2 times in the last 6 months. Just go ahead and invest it. Maybe the potential of that company is only that much. So the race is over. The party is over there. So please don't go ahead and don't invest in that stock. You need to understand, as I explained in part one, that you should know how to identify your entry point and your exit point. We will have a separate detailed video about it. Now coming back, what am I trying to say is you should spend time to study what are the impact of investing in this company and at what level should I invest in this company. Don't think that, okay, I missed the chance of buying the company X or I missed the chance of buying the company Y and it went up. Maybe if I would have bought it before a month, I would have made so much. But the point is you did not buy it before a month, because before a month you did not have the conviction about that company. So it's okay. Either you were not aware of it. So now keep your eyes and ears open. Read about different companies, what are they doing, what are the future plans, and then select your companies appropriately. We are going to cover how do we select the next opportunity that's going to come in our future videos. And the last point, good market. So today the Sensex went up by 200 points, the Nifty went up by 100 points, XY, my decision is right or not. Just for example, in the month of January 2018, if you would have observed, or if you were a little bit closer to the market, you would have observed that most of my friends had seen their portfolio become red to deep red. Whereas if you look at the Sensex and the Nifty in January 2018, it rallied like anything. So the Sensex and the Nifty went up by a very good percentage, but the portfolio of every shareholder in the stock market was red. You can go and check on different forums which are available for discussion, and they will say that I'm not understanding that the Sensex is going up, but my portfolio is turning red stock by stock. It's because the Sensex has certain number of shares that will call it to be a red or a green. Same way, Nifty 50 also has the top 50 or 50 shares whose price will decide whether the color is red or green. And out of the Nifty 50 also, not all of the 50 shares were growing up. There were only particular shares whose weightage was more was growing, and you felt that the market is going up. But you should understand that if you are investing, you should invest, understand the business, and then only invest in it. Wishing you all the very best, my friends. Stay with us, stay connected, continue to learn, and Please subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.